Hello students, I am Sarita Mishra, DM School, RIE, Bhubaneswar. Children, today we are going to learn Shapes and Angles, which is Chapter 2 of Class 5. From your lower classes only, you are acquainted with so many types of shapes, triangle, rectangle, etc. But do you know what are open shapes and what are closed shapes? Let us start our discussion from open shapes and closed shapes. Along with that, today we will discuss angles around us, angle and its parts, and types of angles. So, let us start our discussion from open shapes and closed shapes. See, here I am drawing some curves. Is this closed? No. Why? See, I have started from here. This is my starting point. And I have done like this. And this is my ending point. Do they meet? No. So, this is called an open shape. Whereas, if I draw the same curve like this. See, where I have started from this point and ended at the same point. So, this is a closed shape and this is a open shape. Open shapes can be made with curves or may be made with straight lines. See, this is open. What about this? You will say, ma'am, you have created a loop here. Isn't it closed? No, because as I said, for a closed shape, the starting point and the ending point must meet together. Do they meet here? No, I have started from here and ended here. So, though a loop, a closed figure is created, but this is not a closed figure. This is a open shape. Open, whereas, this one closed shape. So let us see some more shapes. See, in the first column I have drawn some open shapes and I have marked them with arrow mark. See, this is open, open and open. But here I have drawn some closed shape where the starting point and ending point meet together. If you can observe, these closed shapes either made with curved lines or made with straight lines. Let's go to the next slide. See, here I have made some closed shapes for you. In the first column, I have used only curved lines to make the closed shapes. But in second column, I have only used straight lines or line segment to make the closed shape. But in the third column, I have used both, that is curve and lines. So, we conclude that closed shapes can be made either of curves or straight lines or both curves and straight lines. Again, if you observe carefully, you can see these closed shapes make some corner here. See, you know from your lower classes that this is a triangular shape or called triangle made of three sides and three corners are made here. These corners are called angles. Look at this shape. This is a rectangle. Here, four corners are made and that there are four angles in this shape. Look at this. This is called a pentagon having five sides and five angles. And this one a hexagon having six sides. Look here. I have marked the angles with color pencils. This is triangle having three angles. rectangle having four angles, and this one how many? A pentagon having five angles. This is hexagon having six angles, and so on. Children, we can see many angles around us. Even our nature is full of this type of angles. Look at this picture. This is a branch of a tree. Here I have marked the angles created by the branch of the tree. See, this one yellow, this one and this one. You can see many angles on the branches of a tree. Look here. Even in the open mouth of a bird, you can find an angle. Isn't it interesting? Look at the open mouth of this alligator. Isn't it creating an angle? Yes, children. Mathematics is really very interesting. Let us take some more examples. Look at this leaf. Look here. This is the twig, and these leaves are attached to this with certain angles. If you see carefully, you can observe that. Even look at this one leaf. This is the midrib and the side ribs. They are also making angles with the midrib. See, creating a beautiful pattern. How interesting nature is, isn't it? See, I have some more things for you. This is a kite. See, this kite also has four angles with it. In your home also you can find many angles. Look at the scissor, the two arms of the scissor making angle. You can increase this angle like this, and you can decrease this angle. Okay, even a vegetable cutter from my kitchen, I have brought it. This is also making angle. See, this one and this one. If you have observed at your home, all of you have wall clocks like this. See, the angles of the clock also make angles with each other. Can't you see? See, this angle you can increase or decrease. Like this. Okay, children? See, some of the furnitures at your home, doors, windows, walls, everywhere you can find angles like this. Even you can make angles using your body. Look at this boy. Here, his arms are making angle like this and like this one. You can try it at home. See. Okay, so what is an angle and what are its parts? Let us learn. As you have observed, the angle is a plane figure made of two arms. These are the two arms of the angle, and this is the angle formed. This point, they are meeting at one point. This point is called vertex. We name the angle with any three letter. So here ABC is an angle. we can name with any three letter, P, R, Q, any three letter you can take for naming. So, an angle is a plane figure formed by two rays meeting at a common point. Only meeting, not intersecting. See, if two straight lines intersect like this, also angles are formed. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, this is the common point where the two straight lines meet or intersect. Now, what are the parts of an angle? Let us see. As I have already expressed, these two red rays I have drawn are arms of the angle, and the yellow shaded part is called interior of the angle and the outer part is called exterior of the angle, and this common point is called vortex. As I have explained here, this part you may shade and this is called interior and the outer part is called exterior. Let us discuss again. These two are the arms of the angles. The yellow shaded part is the interior of angle and the common point B where the two ray meets is called vortex and the outer part is called exterior of the angle. Now, how do we measure an angle? What is the unit used to measure an angle? You know, to measure length we use meter, centimeter, kilometer, etc. To measure weight we use kilogram, gram, etc. So, what unit is used to measure an angle? The unit used to measure an angle is called degree. It is denoted by a symbol, say here ABC is of 60 degree. We write it little above and this symbol is degree symbol. You may ask, from where does this degree come? Let us make angle with a thread and some pins. I have made it and showing you here. See, the two ends I have fixed like this. Now, this is my movable end. When the two arms coincide like this, so what is the measure of the angle? That is zero, nothing, because the two rays are coinciding. When we are increasing like this, see, the amount of angle is increasing. See, now this becomes just like a shape of L in English alphabet, which is called a right angle. Let us move this like this. See, this is more than right angle. We can move this. Look here. Now, this is forming a straight line, making it a 180 degree angle. If we go on like this, increasing the angle, it will complete a full circle. Okay, let us do it again. Increase, 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 right angle, then this is called obtuse angle. We will learn the types of angles after this. This is straight angle. Again increase this, more than straight angle, and the complete rotation makes it a circle or a complete angle. See here, why I have explained this? This circle makes a complete angle. Starting from zero, the whole circle is divided into 360 parts. Each part is of 1 degree. The degree measurement has taken from here. So, we use this to measure the angles. How to measure angles and how to construct these angles, we will learn in second part of this lesson. So, let's discuss our next point, that is types of angles. Our first angle is zero angle. An angle of measure 0 degree is called zero angle. I have constructed it for you and I have named it BAC and its measure is 0 degree. Some of you may be confused, ma'am, how an angle is of 0 degree? So look at this again. Here I have explained it. Here this is the first arm of the angle and this is the second arm of the angle. See, when they coincide with each other, one upon another. So what is the measure of the angle here? Nothing, that is zero. So we have started from 0 degree. So, 0 degree angle is called zero angle. This can be constructed like this, a ray upon another one. Our next angle is acute angle. Acute, yes, small and cute, because these angles are small. An angle measures more than 0 degree but less than 90 degree. They are called acute angle. Why acute? Because they are small and cute, and you can use this to show so many acute angles. See, from here 1, 2, 3, like this, so many acute angles you can show, up to less than 90 degree. If it is 90 degree, then it is not acute, it is a right angle. See, sometimes some of you are confused. This acute angle may be opening to the left side, maybe to the right side, or maybe to the down, or maybe to the up also. So this is all about acute angle. Next come to our the next type of angle, as I have told, this is right angle, which resembles the letter L of the English alphabet. This one I have made here. See, L, 90 degree. Okay, so an angle of measure 90 degree is called right angle. Next part, our next angle is obtuse angle. An angle of measure more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. That is more than a right angle but less than a straight angle. It is called obtuse angle. Obtuse means fat. Is this angle fat? Little bit. Okay, so this angle is called obtuse angle. You can show it here. See, after right angle, if we'll increase the angles like this, you can see obtuse angles are formed up to when it becomes straight angle. Okay, so next is our straight angle. An angle which measures exactly 180 degree is called a straight angle. Why straight angle? Because this resembles a straight line. Here I have named the angle as DEF, which is equal to 180 degree. These two angles are extra. This is not in your syllabus now, but you should know about it, that after 180 degree angles exist or not. Yes children, as I have explained you, angles more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree are called reflex angle. We can form the angles here. Here we have made 180 degree, just a straight line. If you will go on rotating the thread like this, see, this is one angle. And what about this? This is also an angle. So these angles, which are more than straight angle but less than this 360 degree, that is complete angle, are called reflex angle. Next one is our complete angle, that is an angle which measures exactly 360 degree is called a complete angle. It resembles a circle. We have done it here, that complete rotation making it 360 degree like this, a complete angle. Okay, so these are all about types of angles. Now children, I have made this device to measure angles. Actually, in your instrument box there is a instrument called protractor which can measure angles, that we'll discuss in second part. So today I have not brought that knowingly, so that I'll cover that in second part. I have made this device to make it interesting, so that you can learn whether angles are greater than right angle or smaller than right angle. So this is a simple one. You can make it at home using any two sticks. I have used two ice cream sticks to make a right angle. Okay, so this one will use to measure the angles we have here, whether they are more than 90 degree or less than 90 degree. See, I have a kite here. Let us check. So what do you observe? This is exactly equal to 90 degree. So this is a right angle. Now what about this angle? This is also right angle. This is also right angle. So all the four angles of this kite are right angle. What about the angles formed by this scissor? See. Oh, this is smaller than a right angle. So what type of angle is it? It is an acute angle. If I'll increase the opening of the scissor and keep my device on it, what you'll observe? Now this is more than a right angle, which is an obtuse angle. Like this you can measure whatever you have with you. See, this one less than right angle. Now take this clock. All of you know how to read time? Obviously, you are in class 5, most of you know that. What is the time now? It is 7:30. Now look here, the hour hand and the minute hand are making one angle with each other. Is it more than right angle or less than right angle? Let us check with our device. This one arm, I will just keep it on the minute hand of the clock and check. Oh, this is quite small. So at 7:30, the clock is making an acute angle. Now let us increase the time. See, it is 7:10. Now keep your device. Oh, it is greater than 90 degree. That is more than a right angle. That means what type of an angle is it? It is an obtuse angle. Let us do some more experiment. See, now the hands of the clock are making a right angle. What time is it? It is 6:50. So like this you can experiment at home with angles and enjoy. Children, I have taken 2 pages of your book so that you can understand some exercise. Here, look at the shape and answer. The angles marked in dash color is the biggest angle. Look carefully. Can you guess? Is any angle bigger here or they are of same measurement? If you look carefully, you will find that all the angles here are of same measure. Okay, look carefully, you can observe it. Next question is, are the angles marked with the yellow equal? See, this one yellow, this one yellow. Are they equal? Can you guess? Yes, they are equal. Can you tell me why? Because this is also a pentagon and this is also a pentagon. Here, the angles are equal. Why they are equal? You will learn in your higher classes. Next, are the angles marked with green equal? See, they are also equal. Now, I have taken one more question from your book. Look at the angles in the pictures and fill the table. First one, a scissor marked here. What type of angle is it? This is, obviously, you can see it is smaller than a right angle. That is less than a right angle. Now, look at the man. He is making an angle with his hand. This angle. This is equal to a right angle. Next, a kite. This one is also a right angle. Now, this instrument you must have seen your mother using in kitchen. So, what type of angle is formed here? This is more than a right angle. What type of angle is it? It is obtuse angle. This one you must have seen on the road. This is a signboard. And what type of angle is this? This is more than a right angle. So, this is an obtuse angle. Here, another question I have taken. 4 different angles are marked in 4 colors. Can you find other angles which are the same as the one marked in red? Mark them in red. Do this for the other color. Okay. So, just see. The shapes which are similar must have equal angles. So, this one and this one are similar. These two are similar and these two are similar. See here. I have marked it for you. This one green. This angle is equal to this angle. Here, this one equal to this one, and black and this angle. I have 2 interesting assignments for you. What you will do after learning these shapes and angles? You will make different types of angles using your body. So, what we'll do, you'll make different angles using your body part. And next one is, try to make different shapes using matchsticks and try to recognize the type of angles in them. I have made one for you. See, first one with 3 matchsticks. This is a triangle. Do you need this device to measure these angles, whether more than right angle or less than right angle? I don't think so, because after 3-4 times you do it, you can guess it easily that these angles are smaller than right angle. So, what type of angle are these? These are acute angle. And what is this? With 4 matchsticks, I have made a square. And here, 4 angles are made and each angle is of 90 degrees. See, we can use our device like this. Okay, so here all the four angles are right angle. Like this, I have made here with five sticks a pentagon, a hexagon, and a septagon. Septagons means with seven sides. So you can mark the angle and write what type of angle is it. So this is an assignment for you. You all will do at home and enjoy. So children, let us summarize what we have learned today. We have learned the types of angles, that is zero angle, which measures 0 degree, acute angle, which is greater than 0 degree but less than 90 degree. Then we learn about right angle, which is exactly equal to 90 degree. Next, obtuse angle, which measures greater than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. Next is our straight angle, which resembles a straight line, which measures exactly equal to 180 degree. Next we learn about reflex angles. These angles are more than straight angle but less than complete angle, that is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. Next we learned about complete angle, which angles measures exactly 360 degree is called complete angle, which resembles a circle. So children, hope you have enjoyed learning shapes and angles part 1. Here we have learned only about parts of angles and types of angles. In next part we will discuss how to measure an angle and how to draw angles of certain measures. So that's all for today. Thank you all.